What is up, everybody? I am Legend, and today's video is a Logic Pro X tutorial for beginners. Very basic, just basically how to set up your Logic Pro X session to start recording vocals. Let's dive right in. Logic Pro X is basically the bigger brother to GarageBand. They both have the exact same interface. Logic Pro X just has a lot of more professional features to use, like bus channels. That's the main one I'm going to be talking about. That's the difference between GarageBand, but many other things are included as well. So if we do file new, you're greeted with this option here. So I'm only going to be talking about Logic and GarageBand to record vocals specifically because I produce in machine. So this is going to be specifically geared towards vocals. If you're doing instrumentation, you might want to watch a more in-depth tutorial or more niche tutorial focused on that. But for vocals, so we start here, we have all of our stuff selected. So our audio interface, that's going to be the device here. Now the audio interface is what your mic plugs into, and then that plugs into your computer to where you get your audio. You should know about that. And if you don't, I have a link up here somewhere that explains, you know, how to connect these different things and what they're used for. So we got audio input one, audio output one plus two. This is usually like the default. We just click on create. And then we have here our first track. So before we get into any kind of like putting the tracks in and getting things like, you know, organized, I want to talk about what some of these buttons and features are, the main ones that I use. Basically, we in the top left corner, we have a few different buttons here that's going to allow our navigation to be easier, you know, customizable. So we have all the way to the left side, we have the library button, and this is where we have all of our patches from our vocals that we're going to be using. Now, I mostly use this specifically for my vocal patches that I save and customize myself. And what a vocal patch is, it's basically a preset. So you apply any one of your presets, which I will be selling these presets. By the way, I am in the process of building my very first preset pack, so be on the lookout for that. But anyway, so you can select any preset that you choose to save. Like, let's say I apply some EQ to this particular track. I can choose to save it down here, and then it saves to my user library. And when you select it, it automatically applies this preset, which has this vocal chain. This is my custom chain with all the same exact settings and everything to this vocal. So now if I monitor this,
1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Whereas before it was just 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Very plain, very plain. So this is what the library feature, this is what I personally use it for. Just basically saving my patches. If you're making music and beats and stuff, you can also see that they have sound selection in here as well. But since I don't use Logic for that, I'm not gonna talk about it. If you want to learn more about this, there are plenty of tutorials on YouTube that do talk about this stuff in detail, but I'm gonna try and be as concise and clear and simple as possible. So that's what I use this section for. Then we have the inspector button, which brings up this long window here with the quick help, the audio defaults, the track. It's got our bus channel or whatever channel here on the side, and then our track chain and channel thing here. Make it appear or disappear. So that's what that button does. This question mark button is much like the one in GarageBand, where if you turn it on, every single thing that you hover over, it'll explain exactly what that tool is and its function. I find this to be really useful, even as someone who is well into music production. So this is a really great way for you to figure out what certain things mean, what they are, what they do, because, you know, even I don't know everything. As much as I like to pretend like I do, I don't. So I like to leave that on. So anything, if you can see, I hover over, like over here, for instance, we have the workspace. It says in the top left corner, this is the workspace. Primary area for recording, editing, arranging audio, MIDI, and drummer regions, blah, blah, blah. All that. This is basically where all your audio is going to go, this whole section right here. So I'm pretty sure you already knew that. We have the smart controls button, which enables this menu down here, which is going to be useful for when we have our plugins. We can also click this scissor icon here. This is the editor button. So this is where we chop our audio. So if I record something, and we can make changes and cut things because we opened up the editor button. You can make some really precise stuff in this window down here. So like, I like to use this edit window when I'm recording certain vocals that have precise edits I need to make. I can't make them immediately up here because most of my editing I do in the workspace. But then the editor window is where you can get really clean and concise with your edits. Like if you want to take off just a smidge of this, boom. Then we have the mixer button, which is the one in the middle. This is where all your tracks, once you import everything, they're gonna all line up right here. You can see a broad view of every single track that you have, the stereo out, the master. You can apply plugins in this window as well. The same way you can apply them here. I don't use this too much. I only use this mixer window when I want to get a full picture of all my plugins at once to like see if I can find one that has a incorrect plugin, or I don't know. I just need a broad image of everything. Then of course, next to that, we have our play header, which is pretty self-explanatory. You have your rewind button, your fast forward button, you have go back to the beginning, you have your play, your record, and your loop button. So the loop button here is going to loop whatever you highlight here. So the way that this works is it doesn't, I mean, you can choose to snap to grid if you want to. It should automatically, as you can see, it's kind of snapping right there because it makes it very precise when you're looping different things, but you just choose to loop something and it'll constantly play that section exactly as you want it to do. So that's what the loop button does. Then we have right next to that, this is our project information basically. So it could be whatever you choose to set it as, beats and project or beats and project large. It makes it bigger. It gives you a little bit more information. You could do beats and time where you can see how long your song is. I like the simple view. So as long as I can see the key, the time signature, the tempo, which is right here, the tempo is your BPM, your beats per minute. That's how fast or slow your song is. This is the bar that you're on. So you can see this is bar one, bar two, bar three. So that's what this is counting right here. So if we're at the beginning, you're at bar one, beat one, because it's at the beginning of the first bar, the very first beat. So hello, hello, hello. This is a ramp. That's what that is. If you choose to fast forward to four, this would be bar four, beat one. Bar four, beat one. There you go. This part right here, the key of the song, is what you want to pay attention to if you're going to be using a lot of auto-tune, especially if it's built in. I mean, I would still say set the key of your song regardless, because some plugins do sync with your DAW. So whatever you do, you want to make sure that you change that here so that it coincides with any plugins that may be syncing, or it's just the information that you can use yourself. The plugins that sync, like Outputs Arcade or things like that, you know, you wouldn't have to do that because it automatically recognizes what key it's in based on what you have set. But I always set this stuff first before I even start recording, because that's just the way that GarageBand works as well. Same thing with the tempo. That's gonna be very important for when you have delays and things like that and you want it to be on the correct beat. So that's another thing you wanna pay attention to. So always set the tempo and the key of the song before you do any vocal recording. Now, I'm gonna be honest, I never use any of these buttons right here. I know this is a replace button, this is a tuner button for your instruments, and this is a solo button, but there's a solo button here. This one is the metronome, so this is gonna be the clicks of the beat that you have, so you know that you're on beat. Hello, 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 this is, if you speed it up. So that's your metronome. And then the 1, 2, 3, 4 is your count in. So if I play this right here, it's gonna count me into the, wherever this play header, this is what this line is called, it's the play header. Whatever this is on, it's gonna count me in 4 beats prior to this so that it'll start recording at this moment right here. So. You see what I mean? So this is a good way to punch yourself in when you're recording by yourself, especially for those people who don't have the money to go to a studio or get an engineer to record their vocals for them, to punch them in and all that stuff. This is a great way to punch yourself in. I don't really touch any of this stuff here, so I'm not gonna talk about it. I told you, this is a very basic tutorial. I'm just talking about recording vocals strictly and how I do it. None of this stuff has ever been important to me when recording vocals, so I'm gonna skip it for now. And we have our master volume over here. This is what this bar is. This basically turns everything, if I have multiple tracks here and they're all, you know, different volumes, different levels, whatever, you know. This is great for managing your project from clipping. Sometimes right before I want to master a track with Lander, for instance, I will make sure when I play my song, I make sure this one doesn't go too high in the red. Always monitor the colors on here. If it's in the yellow a little bit, it's okay, but if it's teetering into the red, then you know you're peaking in your volume, so that's when I would turn this down. But sometimes you have so many instruments, so many vocals, that the tracks themselves are not peaking, but since everything's playing at one time, the master volume can be peaking. So that's where I utilize this mostly. If it's like way up there, see how it's going way, it's too loud, so I would turn it down. That's a pretty good volume. Now, since Logic is the bigger brother to GarageBand, once again, a lot of the features are the same. A lot of the things that are included are the same, like Apple Loops. You can use Apple Loops in Logic with all the crazy features that Logic has. So basically, you're taking this really cool feature from GarageBand, putting it into this more powerful DAW, and you know, you get some useful stuff. So you can access the Loops tab here that come with Logic or GarageBand. You just choose to download it and you can make music using their built-in stuff. It's some really great stuff here that's on iPhones, iPads, MacBooks, iMacs. It's all the same stuff. So if you want to, like, you know, basically just drag and drop stuff like that. And it's also going to be in line with whatever BPM you have set. We also have the typical Notepad, but the difference about this one in Logic is you can make notes based on the entire project itself. If I type something here, this is dope. But then also the feature that I like about this, and I didn't notice until this very moment, is it has a track option. So you can make specific notes about this specific track. It's going to be really good for editing audio and when you're going back to mixing things or in the mastering stages and you've recorded all your vocals, or maybe there's some lines that you need to re-record, you don't like it too much. Instead of having to enter everything on the same page here, which you had to do previously in GarageBand that I know of, now you can do individual tracks. So I can come here and say this needs to be turned up, and we can come to this one and write something totally different. This track is stupid. So you have different notes for different tracks. This needs to be turned up. This track is stupid. Then you have the whole project. This is dope. Which one is it? I don't know. I'm just saying stuff. And then we've got another browser here, which I don't use as well. So since I'm doing the basics, just vocal recording, most of the things that I use are the top middle right here. So we have all our project stuff, our play header, our, you know, inspector windows and libraries and patches on the side, the mixer window at the bottom, or if there's a plugin here, there will be some knobs, which I rarely use. I usually just click onto the plugins here. So this is the way to basically add plugins. I don't have to really dive into my chain right now because this is not that kind of video, but this is where you would add your plugins to this specific track. You could choose to add however many you want until your computer decides to crash, but don't overload it. What you want to do is you want to utilize bus channels. So instead of having every single vocal having all these plugins, you basically want to create a bus channel. So you would click on sends, you would click on bus, and you would go to wherever you're sending the track to. So if I click bus one, here's our bus one, and let's add CLA vocals. It's gonna be stereo, and we can add more of the effect by turning up this knob here. So if we add some reverb here, make it kind of dramatic, we turn this up, test, 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 one, two, three. So this is how intense. That's how intense the effect is. How much of this is like the mixed of the effect. It's kind of like having a dry and wet vocal on a reverb. It's the same thing here. You're just turning up how much of that effect you're getting, or how much of everything you apply on this you're getting. So when it comes to utilizing Logic just for vocal production, which is what I do, this is basically essentially the only tools that I use in Logic. I'm sure there's others that I could speak about, but for the time being right now, to record all of my albums, this is exactly the process that I go through and all of the buttons and things that I use and pay attention to. In my next video, when I talk about how to record the vocals itself, I'll speak more about the vocal chain, what to apply where, how to actually press the record button and record your vocals, do comping, or you know, whatever else I talk about, you know, panning your vocals. I will be including a custom made default preset pack for Logic. If you have any questions or comments, let me know down in the comment section below. I will be here, as I always am, to answer people's questions and comments. Like the video, share the video, all that good stuff, and I love you, appreciate you, stay legendary.